Dear students, I welcome you back to our second session of a discussion on the lesson The Move by Farooq Sarwar. This lesson is prescribed for first semester BSc, Bengaluru North University. This is Alice Chirian, Assistant Professor, Department of English, Government First Grade College, Kiyapuram. Dear students, in the last class, we discussed how courage is not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. To be courageous, to be brave, does not mean total absence of fear. It means that person has conquered over the fear, or he has faced it and he has been triumphant. So the lesson, as we studied, is an allegory, you know, trying to teach us or trying to tell us how each individual has his own share of fears in life. But to be brave is to face those fears. Our narrator is very fearful of the dreaded, and he's very dreadful about the wolf that is waiting to devour him, waiting to shred him to pieces. It is standing below the tree, waiting for the narrator to come down so that it can pounce on him. Thus, the narrator takes shelter in tree. He takes shelter in tree to protect himself from the vicious wolf standing below, the cruel wolf. He has all the comforts on the tree. The tree is a magical tree. It provides all his comforts. If he desires for a soft, cozy bed, the tree provides him instantly. If he desires of any delicacies, food, anything, the tree provides it. If he wishes to watch TV, the tree provides it. He's very comfortable. All comforts are provided. However, the point to be noted is he is not happy. All these physical comforts do not give him happiness because he has no freedom. His life is limited to his living on the tree. He seeks freedom. He wants to be free. He wants to get down. However, he does not have the courage to face the wolf. Freedom comes with a price. And the price is he need to get down, face the wolf, and kill the wolf to be free. So this is an allegory of our individual self. Many a times we limit ourselves. We live in a comfort zone, worried, scared about the unknown. But the moment we decide to go out and face those fears is when we are really free. It is when we get our freedom. This was a brief recapitulation of our discussion in the previous session. Going further, we discuss the nightmares our writer has. He has no sleep. You know, the thoughts of the wolf chasing him causes him to have cold sweats. See, fear can be traumatic. He has no peace. He has nightmares. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮರದ ಮೇಲೆ ಆಶ್ರಯ ಪಡೆದಿರುವ ನಮ್ಮ ಲೇಖಕನಿಗೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಲೇಖಕನಿಗೆ ಏನು ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಂಫರ್ಟ್ ಆ ಮರದ ಮೇಲೆ ಸಿಕ್ಕರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅವನಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂತೋಷವಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವನಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಸಮಾಧಾನವಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಅವನಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೂ ಆ ಭಯ ಇದೆ, ಅವನ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಅಡ್ಡಿ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಭಯ. ಏನ ಭಯ? ಆ ಕೆಳಗೆ ನಿಂತಿರುವಂಥ ಆ ತೋಳ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ನನ್ನನ್ನು ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೋ ಅನ್ನುವ ಭಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವನು ದುಸ್ವಪ್ನ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅನೇಕ ರೀತಿಯ ನಿದ್ರಾಹೀನತೆ, ಡಿಪ್ರೆಷನ್, ಫಟೀಗ್, ಇದೆಲ್ಲವನ್ನ ಹೇಗೆ ಅನುಭವಿಸ್ತಾನೆ? ದೇಹದಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಆ ದಣಿವು, ಅನಾರೋಗ್ಯ, ನಿದ್ರಾಹೀನತೆ ಇವುಗಳಿಂದ ಬಳಲ್ತಾನೆ. ಹೇಗೆ ಭಯ ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಹದ ಮೇಲೂ ಪರಿಣಾಮ ಬೀಳುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಈ ಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ. ದ ನೈಟ್ ಮೇರ್ಸ್, ಯುನೋ, ದ ಸ್ಲೀಪ್ಲೆಸ್ ನೈಟ್ಸ್. ದೋ ಹಿ ಫೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಸೊಲೇಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಥಾಟ್ ದಟ್ ಟ್ರೀ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಟಾಲ್ ಒನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೇಫ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀ, ದ ವುಲ್ಫ್ ಕೆ ನಾಟ್ ಹಾರ್ಮ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಈ ರೀತಿ ತನ್ನನ್ನು ತಾನು ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಸಾಂತ್ವನ ಪಡಿಸಿಕೊಂಡ್ರು ಕೂಡ, ಮರ ದೊಡ್ಡನಿದು, ಎತ್ತರವಾಗಿದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತೋಳ ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವಿಲ್ಲ, ನಾನಿಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇಫ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೇನೆ ಅನ್ನುವ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಆಲೋಚನೆಗಳಿಂದ ತನ್ನನ್ನು ತಾನು ಅವನು ಸಮಾಧಾನ ಪಡಿಸಿಕೊಂಡ್ರು. ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಒಂದ್ ಕಡೆ ಅವನನ್ನ ದುಸ್ವಪ್ನಗಳು ಕಾಡ್ತಾ ಇವೆ, ನಿದ್ರಾಹೀನತೆ, ಭಯ, ಭೀತಿಗೆ ಒಳಗಾಗಿದ್ದಾನೆ. ರೈಟ್? So during the day, he manages rather well, but as the night comes, his suffering begins. Right? During the day, he manages well with these thoughts. No matter what, I'm safe on the tree. The tree is very tall. The wolf can't reach me. These thoughts give him some kind of solace. But when the night comes, he's dreaded. He's dreadful of the fact that the wolf can do anything. You see, many a times this, though day and night just denotes the timing of a day, the brightness and the darkness, even in our lives, when everything goes on well, you know, we comfort ourselves saying that these things may not happen to me. These things may not come to me. However, when the night comes, when the situations turn dire, it is then we are unable to face the actual fact that we are not prepared to face these kind of situations. So as I said, preparation is very, very important, right? So when you prepare in the day, you can fight the night. But whereas this person is dreadful of, he's very scared of the night. As he falls asleep, nightmares trouble him. His body aches badly. He feels totally exhausted. So we see how mind has a great impact on our body. It affects our body when the mindset or the mental situation of a person is not well. Nowadays, the whole world faces not only, you know, a crisis in human health, physical health, but also mental health. And the very sad part of this mental health is many of them don't know that they have issues, in their mental health. Even maybe overthinking is considered to be a part of, an aspect of mental sickness. Overthinking, thinking over the same issue again and again, again and again. But whereas we find it so common, right? So mental health is a great concern today. Therefore, we see how mental health affects the balance of our hormones. And in turn, this leads to a lot of stress or a lot of disturbance in our body, in our health. First of all, sleep is directly related to the peace of our mind. We need to be peaceful to have sleep. It's not how long you sleep. It's how good, how soundly you sleep. So he is not able to sleep. He can't sleep because of this fear. He has nightmares. His body aches. You see how the fear, the mental fear has an effect on his body. Like it starts paining. It is exhausted. We see that he's very comfortable on the tree. He has no reason for physical exhaustion, no reason for fatigue. However, the mere fact that he's so scared of the wolf has caused all these problems to him. Even in our life, many a time we can see the physical manifestation of the fears, like shivering, trembling, not able to talk, not able to express oneself. These are also the physical aspects or the physical manifestations that we can see of the fear in our mind, right? Extreme sweating, right? That's also mentioned here. So this is the traumatic experience our narrator has. But one morning, he finds somebody else hiding in the foliage, in the green leaves, you know, of the tree. Somebody else like him is hiding. He calls him the companion, because even this person, he is like him, worried and afraid, and he has taken refuge in the tree. Refuge here means ashraya, to take shelter, okay? ಒಂದು ದಿನ ಅವನು ನೋಡ್ತಾನೆ ತನ್ನಂತೆ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬ ಕೂಡ ಭಯಕ್ಕೆ ಭಯದಿಂದ ಭ್ರಾಂತನಾಗಿ ಈ ಮರದಲ್ಲಿ ತನ್ನಂತೆ ಆಶ್ರಯವನ್ನು ಪಡೆದಿದ್ದಾನೆ. ಅವನನ್ನು ದ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾನಿಯನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾನೆ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ತೋಳಕ್ಕೆ, ಇವನ ತೋಳಕ್ಕಲ್ಲ ಅವನ ತೋಳ ಬೇರೆ, ಆ ತೋಳಕ್ಕೆ ಎದುರಿ ಅವನೇನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾನೆ, ಈ ಮರದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಶ್ರಯವನ್ನ ಪಡೆದಿದ್ದಾನೆ. ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಇಬ್ಬರ ಟ್ರಾಮಾ ಕೂಡ ಸೇಮ್. ಇಬ್ಬರು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದೊಂದು ತಮ್ಮದೇ ಆದಂತಹ ವಿಷಯಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಭಯ ಪಟ್ಟುತ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. His companion on the tree is escaping from another wolf that is standing below the tree. Both are afraid of the wolf pursuing them. They have all means of comfort on the tree, but they are not happy. So we see that they both are afraid of the wolves. They both are not happy. And therefore, the narrator calls him the companion. Even in our, what is the takeaway that we can find in our lives is, many times we find others who are, you know, fearful of some factors like us in their life too. However, their fear may be totally different than ours. So it is a wise saying not to compare oneself with others, not to compare one's fear with others. It's wise thing. Maybe, it may sound same, but it may vary in the degree of your fearfulness, and also that the wounds may be totally different, you see. So both are afraid, but they are two different wounds, right? Feeling of boredom and oppression is eating into them every passing day. That is, both are comfortable on the tree. They have everything that they need. However, there is a feeling of boredom in them. There is a feeling of oppression in them. And they're really fed up of being on the tree. See, comfort can't make you happy. That is what we are trying to see. Take a person, give him all the comfort on the earth and lock him in the room. What point is that? He would definitely aspire to be free, even if his comforts are reduced. So freedom of mind, freedom of expression, freedom to live in a way that you can express yourself completely is very important for happiness of an individual. So these two people are very, very much oppressed in their life, and they want freedom. But this freedom comes to them only at the cost that they come down, take up their courage, come down and kill the wolf. The frightful image of the wolf has even entered their dream, so that there is no peace for them to sleep to. As I explained it earlier, this fright, this fear has entered their subconscious mind, and it is now reflected even in their dreams. The dream of being attacked by the wolf, the dream of being chased by the wolf, right? So how sometimes our imaginations can become reality in our life. Our insecurities can become realities in our life because we take it too deep. And we start thinking too much over it. So they also face this. They also are unable to face this. They are unable to take this kind of traumatic experience. And there is one more thing. Suddenly they find that the wolf becomes very aggressive. It is raging with wildness and anger. And that, intensifies their fear. And it becomes very difficult for them to stay on the tree. We can also note that the wolves are very strange. The wolf in author's pursuit or chase relates to him only. Similarly, the other wolf relates to the companion, the other fellow. The companion wolf does not bother our narrator. The wolf of which our narrator is scared does not bother the companion. Right? So in this situation, what do they decide? One day they decide that they will get down and face their wolves. They decide to close their eyes and jump. However, our narrator does not jump. He does not, garner that energy, that courage to jump. He remains on the tree. The fellow companion, he jumps down. He takes courage. He jumps down. And the wolf leaps on him and finds him. As soon as it finds him on the ground, it jumps on him. What is the result of this? What will the companion do? Will he survive? Or will he in turn kill his fear? Will he kill the wolf? However, the narrator's wolf is also alerted, and it is waiting for the narrator to jump down. And it gets very wild when it finds out the narrator has not jumped. You see? So this, is what we see in this part of the lesson. How the narrator who finds protection on the tree, finds a companion. They both are not comfortable. Of course, they're comfortable with all their needs, but they're not happy. They're not happy because they do not have freedom. They strive to have freedom, but this freedom has a cost. They need to get down and kill the wolf. One day, they both decide to jump. However, our narrator remains on the tree. The companion jumps down. So in the next session, we will see how these both face their chain, wounds in their lives. And will they be triumphant? Will they overcome their fear? And what is the taste of freedom? How does it feel to be free? These are some aspects that we will be discussing in the next session. Thank you for attending.